Radiant team pick. Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Beastmaster.
Dire team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Witch Doctor.
Radiant team ban. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Should have seen that one coming.
Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Radiant team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Dire team ban. Dire team pick.
Enchantress.
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Puck!
Dire team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Dazzle!
Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time.
Faceless Void.
Dire team ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant team ban. 10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Dire team pick.
Lone Druid.
Radiant team pick. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Seconds remaining. 5 seconds
Life
remaining.
Stealer.
Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Prepare for battle. Thirty seconds to battle.
It's up.
The battle begins.
First blood.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Gotcha!
Double damage!
Bottom is missing.
Radiant structures are fortified. Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Not today.
TV audio is now available. I was getting used to that one. It's a cloud setting now, not a actual local PC setting. So my apologies. TV is back up. Thanks to Blaze for shouting that one out. Stacks up. Final Blade is there. Like you said, the 1 point across. All the abilities trying to get a bit of damage down onto MSS, but Outworld Devourer. Really care too much about it. The bottle up is going to be filled with that bounty rune up at top. Arcane Rune, a nice one to be picked up by Resolution, though. The Brax isn't available to be killed off at bottom lane, and with his Quelling Blade, he can farm through jump gaps relatively easily. And is this just going to be trade off a farm across the board here? Weehar getting himself pretty much a free lane. 29 last hits, 8 denies. We used to see a lot of Midas Lifestealer, but it looks like he's just waiting for the phase boots after this creep.
Yeah. You can always, you can go back to the Midas. That's the builds I've seen recently of the same thing I saw. Usually phase and then either drum or omelet, and then usually the other one of the two, although the order varies. I did once, I think I saw phase into drum and then back to Midas. But that's less usual, I guess. It's kind of like when you go blink. Back to my, it's just like you realize something about the game is that you need that item. It's interesting though, with the farm trade-off, the team's getting their farm. Shazam definitely hit a timing where you're not going to be able to stop their push, especially with that OD aura and the Dazzle Hill spam. Never mind like all of the Necros and Windred stuff. So I feel like DC will have to find a timing where they make kills happen to disrupt that kind of push timing. And if they do, they'll be looking absolutely great. They could snowball kill after kill. But they need it to happen at some point. I think DC will be the team that has more pressure on them to make a move to change something or naturally the farm game leads to Shazam's boom.
Oh, Brax barely TP's out from bottom lane. The damage output wasn't quite there from DC.
Radiant's top tower has fallen.
We're looking at heroes here from DC that need big items. You know, the Puck wants the Blink Dagger, the Lifestealer wants those movement speed and stats items built up, while Faceless Void needs a chunk of damage out from the top lane. He also wants to get himself into Vlad's and Blink, while Shazam don't necessarily need anything apart from the Radiance on the bear, and that's going to be the far priority for them. But we are looking at a team here that can lifesteal a bomb onto people. Fuck plus that lifesteal, looking for maybe a few future skills while MSX has gone on a mid. Cast the grave, no! The cast back onto Jason, they didn't get the save out onto the OD. SVG will try and come in with a haste rune on this Enchantress, but Misery and Resolution pair up very nicely there to kill off the OD.
And that's maybe like a hint that Shazam's gonna get the draft. Not so much, but it will definitely be like that later on where there's limited ways for Shazam to take the fights. You know, Dazzle can try get his grave off, that's the thing he can do. OD could try Astro himself there, but they're not versatile in the sense of like, we could control the enemy hero this way or take this person out that way. And that's why I think the fighting game could be able to be, there's much more options available to them in terms of the execution and fights.
Wondering if Weehaw is in trouble there, but he jumps into a centaur, will steal it. Puts himself back a little. Something else pretty good against this Enchantress. It's going to be difficult to gank into this lifestealer without that roar from the Beastmaster, because he can just do this. Hit control. Jump out whenever he wants to. Door summit. Bad deny.
That's one of them.
Oh, that's a good Malefic. Misery catches that TC and the damage out, but he puts a damage draw. Misery places himself to the retreat from TC. He's going to be closed out here, but with the restoration, he's not going to drop himself. Doom will pick up. Blast it over on that kill. So Chaos tie things up 2-2, and he's going to move in onto mid as well. Resolution, he's hungry, and he's very angry that he got killed off early on in this lane.
I think the damage output of the battle cry there, like all of a sudden Witchstock and Lee died in just a few hits. We don't often call it, but Wonder has got crazy damage he can represent early on. Stops them up pretty easily, that's probably because it's pretty long cooldown. But yeah. The point I want to make before the fight starts is that maybe underappreciated the value of the lifesteal is that it's almost as strong as the most when it comes to killing Enchantress. Because you just use your rage and then gobble it up. Like, Enchantresses are used to, you know, being impervious to death by right click. And lifestealers are one of the few heroes that can just go up to the Enchantress and go HP to dead. Come of rage.
Oh, that's a good point. We are with his max rage coming out now. That's going to be something to look for, but Brax, he's about to hit that level 6 points after the creep wave. He'll have the roar available. Only one more. He's sharing with SVG, but they've got it. Has that roar, and with the OD moving down towards bottom lane, it's all been scouted out by this nice observer ward from DC, so they know this is coming.
And Void and Puck both have Witch Doctors running in, so Dive here could be pretty bad for Shazam, could really backfire.
Oh, SVG, the Hawk, it expires, the smoke is here. Chaos. In from the west, Resolution. He wants to dream call someone, but he needs to find a target first, and it looks like Shazam. Dyer's the deal is coming, there's no one farming mid lane. Resolution has been off map for a good 20 seconds now.
Bottom is missing!
Yeah, SVG. Falling out, bottom is missing, and Enchantress, she knows what's up, and the rest of them, they just hide back across their own side of the river. DC safely in his own jungle. This has wasted a bit of time and a smoke here from DC, but I think they might try and convert this into a push onto tier 1.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, definitely some pushing power on their side. I mean, I spoke about Shazam as being a pushing lineup, and they definitely are much more of a pushing lineup, but DC, if you leave them to tower, they're going to be able to take it down for sure. But it looks like Shazam wants to smoke themselves on a wraparound.
Yeah, looks like it. But no one's TPing just yet. Resolution, this observer ward again. Good vision and warding for both teams, but Resolution doesn't realize he needs spotted the roar from Brax to start things off, and with the stomp, there's more than enough control just to demolish that pot. Center, an alternate dimension. Wishes she didn't really exist, but MSS will continue pummeling away at this tier 1 mid, and I don't think there's any real recourse here from DC, no way to stop it. Let's look to continue pushing onto tier 1 bottom lane, but again we go back to this point, they don't have natural pushing heroes.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Yeah, I mean, Lifestealer can use rage to kill the tower faster. Radiant's middle tower. At some point that actually becomes worth it, especially on TR, he's gonna use it now. The clip was already used, so I think they can either take the tower very low or just finish it off altogether. Backing off just a little bit while the rage is cooling down, but taking some time for Shazam to get there. DC will notice there's no more up. Yeah, the Beastmaster's Hawk completely sets up that kill and resolution, and it's just like one of the many values of Beastmaster and why it's the first pick in the current meta.
TC has his Midas over on his bear. A little bit of a slower build up. He did go for the Bassy's round boots. That all but Venom on lane to deal with the face of the void. He's got double Quelling Blade though. I don't know if you've seen this before, but it's a new one on me. Double Quelling on your Lone Druid and Spirit Bear.
I have not seen it, but it kind of makes sense.
Yeah,
right?
It makes perfect sense. I'm actually looking at this and wondering why we have it or why I haven't seen it before. I know we've seen Iron Talons on the bear, we've seen a Quelling Blade on the bear, but very rarely do we see a Quelling Blade on the hero himself. C spots out move, but this person's void, you know, we're throwing him a Time Walk, just gonna jump himself away, no real unfest there over on him, while bottom tier 1, it'll drop it out the lane. There's no stop. Beastmaster's back to lane, back to Fountain. Another guy's Necrobook finished though. He's hit that level 7.5 point, and he might go and TP run the rest of his team, but...
Dire's bottom tower
kill down at bottom. Grouping up a lot though here. RDC is MSS, sees the faceless Rex, and with one more hit, he's killed off the courier. Nice little bonus for him there.
Dire's
ODU's had an okay laning phase. All of a sudden, things are looking great and shiny.
Is Blue going Midas? Or do you think he might be rushing him? I would guess it's more likely a Midas, right?
Likely Midas against Enchantress and Beastmaster, I guess. Just kill off the summons and the enchanted creeps.
Yeah, I guess that's the play. And in some sense, I mean, the reason I asked with concern in my voice is because I feel like that timing's gonna be as fresh as that, where you want your Void to already be able to set up those Chronos, and if he's just got a Midas, that'd be a mistake. But at the same time, sometimes, similar to how LGD were that phase a few months ago, where they kept picking Morphling against push lineups, I feel like going for Midas does a similar thing where force the push lineup to be hurried in finishing the game because they recognize that you're actually out farming and put the Doom on your team as well as the lifesteal in the pack if you have a Midas in your Void. I think you can get into that position where suddenly Shazam really feel like they have a small window, but as I say that, I see Mu actually has the male sort of city, so he's gonna go the fighting route.
Well, we still are waiting for, well, Saxa finally hits his level 6, but we're still waiting for Misery to hit his level 6. We're looking at the two supports on Dire being level 7 already. Let's go over to looking at net worth and relatively even. What's even the lead here? 1500 for Shazam. Is that just from the extra tier 1 they've brought down? We got another tier 1 down the bottom lane as well. Not as close so far, but this timing window you're talking about where Shazam, they're going to have Enchantress creep, Beastmaster ball with the Aurora, and Necro 1 is now available and on its way down to him. Well, I've got a plan for your OD to farm as well. But we've also got to look at the fact that Shazam are Dire side. Because the fact that they are on this Dire side means that if they get a pick off on one or two heroes here, going into Roshan is so bloody simple for them. With an OD and Arcane Orb to shred through him.
They will want to get the pick off first, because otherwise they're setting up for the Void and the Witch Doctor in the pack. Resolution TPing down to the bot lane. Just to farm, so they're gonna pull back. They're not gonna try and push the tier 1 mid.
Bottom is missing.
The big timing window for me is actually the final form, like the Necro 3 as well as the Radiance. I think that's sort of the will be the sweet spot where Shazam know that they can push and it's very difficult to stop them. Especially with because Dazzle have maxed out heal and they've got OD Aura, which means they've got infinite Dazzle heal, so you can't spam that kind of push back. You have to actually win a fight. And so either before then or at that stage, DC needs to find a way to win some fights.
DC has so much money saved up, closing on 3,000 now, 15 minutes in. Oh, he's not far away, but Resolution has the money for his Blink Dagger, and this is the kind of counterplay here for them. Once you've got these Lifestealer Bombs to jump in onto heroes like OD and Enchantress, they're squishy, and in close quarters, they're not the best fighters or battlers. Shazam only really have this Dazzle to try and save them, so Jason has to be quick on his toes and quick with the fingers, reacting with his Graves and Heals to try and save up the rest of his team members. Finally, Misery gets himself some levels. Bit of farm and XP priority back over to him. This death ward, might be a smoke here, but there's the jump in. Armlet ready, blink available. This is perfect from DC, as long as they can find, you know, a solitary target, maybe Jason's Dazzle.
Sarks and they've
him
got
up.
The Doom hiding as well.
Oh, you're right, stacked it in from behind. They jump in with a pistol of the DC, Dazzle puts the bag of the odds, moves forward a little bit further, but look at the positioning of this Dazzle. Jason knows that if he sits close enough here, he can heal the Grave. Oh no, he can't! Oh, Jason. He thought he had it, but he might have lost his own life for this one as well. Tries to keep himself out as an infernal blade in 1 second's time. The stun comes through and it's cleared up as well. Grave not even thrown onto himself. Dazamel and two heroes there where it looks so good for them to turn it around. Now they're looking for SVG as well. Resolution, blink forward with the smoke. He's got the orb damage as well, but they don't have the slow or anything to actually hold him in place.
This is the thing, that the Enchantress are dealt with nearby, and they almost saw the gang coming. But again, what? Okay, well, here we see Lax Healer, chomp, chomp, chomp. I think Enchantress
And now Brax is TP'd into a chrono. Oh, Chris Dodd is gone. But OD, looking to turn this one back around as Moose climb, walks himself back up onto the cliff. It's pretty unfortunate there, they wanted to chrono into Death Ward to kill off Brax.
Yeah, so the thing I wanted to say about the Enchantress and the Dazzle, they're nearby, they see the gang captain and their lone druid, but their options to help are limited, like healing and ice picking basically, and another one to get the grave and the heal off, but I'm not even completely sure that they would be able to turn it around with that. Because normally to turn something like that around, you know, if one of your supports is a Witch Doctor and you turn around and throw the Cars Guard and then everyone turns and attacks, that's one thing, but all of their representatives are healing and makes sense to protect the Roshan out. Can't really be contested with the Chrono down, and they'll get the Roshan. They'll probably start pushing sometime soon. I don't think they'll be able to wait for. Maybe they'll try and wait for the Radiance, I'm not sure.
Far away, is it? That death seems to be dropped. A little bit of money. OD, what have you got? Drums? This does consolidate the position and allow him to go into that Blink Dagger or the Rod of Atos with a lot of safety. Go for that mobility item or the catch item for the Earthworm Devourer. Keep capturing the opponent. Force staffing built up by Jason as well, knowing that he needs that positioning tool. Teammate from this DC squad. Resolution up at top, all alone. With the Doom going back for a Midas now as well. I'm wondering, Chad, does Resolution think about the same? We used to see this a lot with the blink back into Midas.
Hang on, look what Weehill's doing. She's got an Ancient and went to the block. But yeah, it is possible for Resolution to go back for that. Like, guarantee the late game build, because it does feel like Shazam has a bit more of a window. Even though Shazam's lineup definitely has very strong carrying power, I just feel like they have a window because they're not very versatile in controlling fights, and I think that's actually important in the late game. So I think that could make sense, but it looks like Resolution's going straight for the Axe. Doesn't even hesitate. I was gonna say he might even consider the Veil, which would be nice. We've seen that recently on Axe, but he wants an Axe. Isn't Attack Axe usually to do with the enemy team going BKB? Like,
yeah.
But guess you expect Odie to get a reasonably early BKB, is that the...
I'm really unsure about this. I mean, it tanks you up as a part, so like, fair enough, the stats are pretty good, but... I mean, you just look at the actual upgrade of the puck. Aghanim Scepter over my Dream Coil, and it's always been about that BKB, negating up back different opponents, but... I don't know, there's lots of options here for Resolution. You could have gone for Yule Scepter, maybe you could have gone back for... even the Dagon if he wanted to, but never know, it could be Point Booster and the Staff of Wizardry could be still the Yule Scepter if he wants to go that direction and go that route.
Doubtless. I mean, he bought both items. I think he's going Axe, and maybe it's not just about the BKB, maybe like he tries him in general. I mean, it's... I don't know. But Beastmaster's got Necro 3 now. That's the one piece complete, and do we see Lone Druid Radiance yet? Where is the Spirit Bear?
Spirit Bear is back in base. Got it.
Relic.
He's got the Radiance Recipe on the floor. He has finished it up.
So this is the timing window. This is the... Now, it's actually so big, because they've got the Aegis as well. And this is... I feel like the game is never going to be more favorable for Shazam than it is right now in the next 5 minutes.
Oh,
it's
got the switch right in there with the roar as well. This looks going to be dropped. Emmett sends the Doom onto him, the Grave on the back as well, there's the Rambus. Oh, boom! 3-man Chrono down to the last of Shazam. The TC taking no damage, maybe something OD's going to get popped out here with the Enchantress back onto that Void as well. But Moon's cleared up one. And OD returns to the land of battles and destruction, but we are still has that Rage available up against that Outworld Devourer Arcane Orb. Still with a blink forward, we are in a ton of trouble. This little boy to get himself back home, but Shazam come out, lose their offlaner and their support, but they take down the puck and the lifestealer, and they can convert this into maybe a tier 2.
they'll want to, but I don't know if they're going to be able to. Yeah, they want to go back and actually stop. Don't want to give them that split pushing value with his Maelstrom, because I mean, I said it's more feisty than Midas, but it's still a split pushing item in addition to that. Sure, it's a win push for them. There's not a huge win, but they lost the Aegis as well. And I think to some extent that's because we've got a really nice Chrono on the back line. I think with Doom using his ulti on the early stages, the other heroes get involved quickly, it could have been a bit of a mask for the. So I think if you're DC, you'll be perfectly fine with that. And they, again, I expect the DC know that this is like the hardest part of the game.
Oh, they jumped in mid, right? This time, Brawl, it's Resolution, he tried to go for the kill, but with that Spirit Bear ripping through them, Sax, they didn't need an entangle here, the Castle Mountain back and forth, and Varys being caught a little bit in mouth, he's onto a bit of a Death Ward drop, Rax, he's dropping low as well, there's no grave, yes there is, Jason catches it just at the tip. But I think Brax is still pretty rogered here as he's chased down. No damage, no tick, nothing doing. Necro books to pop back out and Wheeze being ripped from Crit. The entangle comes through for TC as well, and this Lifestealer trapped in place. Four heroes gone from DC, and the fifth one is the Faceless Void. Time dilation's there, but the damage from MSS clears him up with a Sanity's Eclipse. Five man wipe for two in return. They turn it from one measly 2-for-2 exchange to a big old teamfight win.
You see, putting themselves so far. I mean, if you look around the map, you'll notice that DC don't have any points up at all. Zero vision on that. And they initiate on the beast. I'm pretty sure they think he's a boy. They're gonna just get a kill, but he has two allies nearby. And then the fight, then there's like a stage where they feel like, oh, we can actually turn around anyway. But again, same fact applies. You just don't know where the enemy team is. And I was just talking about how this is like maybe the most favorable window of the game for Shazam, and if you're DC, you don't want to be looking for fights under unfavorable conditions or not having any vision on the map. So I think that DC just need to, you know, relax a bit. Store that vision, recognize that I mean, they do want to fight, but they want to take fights that they think they can, not just like see a hero, okay, everyone charge kind of thing.
Go back to that fight that we saw, the little one over on this ramp. It kind of felt, I don't know, like North Korea against South Korea. There's like this demilitarized zone on that ramp where no one wanted to go up, and Shazam couldn't go down because of that Chrono over in the back. It's just like Necro units and boars and all sorts of nonsense and stuff being thrown from Shazam into the faces of DC. They don't have good ways of dealing with it, and the cask, sure enough, it bounces between those units. But that means it's cask bounces wasted that aren't going onto heroes, that aren't going onto the Spirit Bear. This allowed TC to get himself a full Vladimir's finished. He's got boots over in his bear as well. Shazam looking good stead, honestly, with 4,000 gold at MSS. To an ultimate orb, I'm wondering, is that just gonna be a hex for him? Or are you looking for... Well, I guess Lincoln's fear against the Doom is pretty good.
Yeah, Lincoln's is pretty good. Even if it just blocks a cask or lifesteal is slow, that's also good value this game. I wouldn't be that surprised if he goes for that, although Hex is always great value on early too. But I like the way you're describing early, because I think it really puts things into nice perspective. Like, I'm talking the whole time about how I think DC gain an advantage the later the game goes because they better control, even though they might not out-carry. And the reason that I think Shazam is a favorable win right now, and you're hinting at it yourself, is that there's just too many things Shazam presents that need to be controlled at this stage in the game, and it doesn't matter the enemy's control. They have to control your necro creeps. Control your Enchantress creeps, they have to control your really overfarmed Odi, really overfarmed Lone Druid. Like, there's even just the Enchantress's attacks. So, having extra control only starts being the key factor once you get past a certain where, you know, you're not being swarmed and overwhelmed by what Shazam have. And Shazam, I think, are going to try and push that advantage. They were hoping to get a pick one before they push this tier 2, but I'm pretty sure they'll go for the tier 2 nonetheless.
It's only a 2,000 gold lead here, or net worth lead for Shazam, so it kind of feels a little bit deflating. Yeah, the team fights and the way they're pushing into these towers, and I guess it's just good play by DC and the ability to keep their farm up, and obviously the Midas out for this little Doombringer hit level 11, but defending your base. That's the name of the game, the Ancient. Can't let that one fall, and with the Spirit Bear, with these Necrons up on the high ground. Ritual Chaos, they have got a lot of work to do. Resolution is waiting over in the wing, ready to backstab and jump into this fight if he wants to, and he's waiting for the moment to strike, but it's not there. Turns to his base. Ritual Chaos turns to the top of their ramp.
Yep. So, I would say that the next 1 or 15 fights are very likely to set up the end of the whole game. I think that DC will be favored if they come out of those on top. I mean, it would still be like anyone's game, but I think they'd be favored. And I think right now Shazam are probably favored for the next close fights. So, if DC are able to get some nice fights, like with this Lifestealer Pack Bomb, or they get some quick pickoffs. Especially now, while there's no Aegis on the side of Shazam, it could be very good for them. Especially if there's a winner fight and Guild Rush themselves, that could be like absolutely game changing.
Resolution with Weehar. They're still looking for this. I feel a bomb hasn't worked out once this game with the Aghanim Scepter running. Weehar just gives up and says, screw it, I'm going back to farming, mate. Point in wasting any more time, we've got no idea where Shazam are. Again, back to your point about warding and vision. One Radiant Observer ward up on the high ground towards top rune spot, while the Dire don't have too much either. Ward in the Radiant Jungle, but they do have Hawks and stuff to give them that little bit of added extra value. You know, the Roshan's alive and it's something they can get ready to take as well. Three is solo farm on top lane.
Look at it go! Because they have the Hawks and also because most of their game plans are creeping up. So it's not nearly as bad if you get the Hawks and you get the right off the main center, some big factor in terms of one of their spells or control factors working out really well in the next fight, or it could be difficult then.
They don't have great chrono synergy though. Like Death Ward plus chrono is one thing, but without having any really good cause to throw damage into the chronosphere, the void, be an amazing setup for any actual damage output, and they're instantly spotted as smoke breaks, DC. Not getting anything out of it. It's a long walk from top lane through mid and then back through the room jungle for where Shazam were hiding.
What he did with the chrono last time was just to chrono the back lines while the two flanners were fighting, and I think that's probably actually the idea for chrono at this point. Just like let your team fight one or two heroes and just distract everyone else for a while. And in the process, Crackle was down. He actually did do that in the previous fight. He managed to use his chrono to distract some heroes and kill a Dazzle. That's pretty like best case.
Oh man, look at this. High ground observed for Tornado is out for the Wild Thing. Spirit Bear on the high ground. Brax still holds up Necro 3 and they've got the jump. Heck, MSS has a good look. The chrono's down for Muzo. Broken down as that was Baron, but we hold ward up. And then we just turn it to fight. The two mods are here, he doesn't really care about the stun of this. He's a great double guard. The Brax is still on the front line. We hold trying to shred them. And he will get that kill. But it's still Shazam holding this position. We hold sacks of resolution. He got back into the game on his part. They're going to jump forward. Still no damage output here from DC, and Weehar chased back into Fountain and taken out of the game. Shazam in a great position. These buybacks, they have to pay off here. They've got to do something with this, and they're all forward aggressively looking for a jump. But it's Resolution on his own again. They've got no one to follow through on this except the cast bouncing back between them, but Resolution's linked back already.
Radiant
this Dire Squad, full retreat time. I think they'll just give up SVG. He'll be the master, the sacrificial lamb. The rest of the team bails out of this. No bash, nothing left for Mood to give. SS will also retreat, so tier 3 does drop. That was an Aegis expended. DC though, triple buyback is what they had to pay.
Yeah, I think DC will be frustrated because they've had two kind of decent fights, but both of them, I mean this one wasn't nearly as good as the previous one, but both of them they have to use the Doom on the Aegis, and I just feel like any time that's the trade-off that you have to take, you're probably going to be losing out. That's I think why they buyback, they want to kill the Oni again. But they did not succeed doing that, and Odie actually finds the 3 now.
Oh, misery. Oh, dear. Even the Blink draw. Oh, smooth. Jumped away. He got into fog just in time, and Brax's Blink was a little short there. Resolution retreats as well.
Missing middle.
Still on the hunt for this Shazam. They know that they're ahead, and they know they can keep pushing this advantage further and further and getting more value out of this game, because without buybacks on three bigger heroes, the Doom, Puck, and Lifestealer, relying on a big chrono here from Mood to really catch people off guard, but he's gone back into the BKB after Maelstrom, as well as that Blink Dagger.
Yeah, I mean, the game could end Radiant bottom barracks are under attack. Because they can't spam out the first,
Radiant
just because of the Odi Aura and Dazzle Heal combo. And that means to stop the push, they have to win a fight. They don't have any buybacks. There's the hit, that's one good thing for them. But they're gonna have to win the fight at some point. They're gonna have to win it.
That's Lucian, if you want them. But I don't know about this one. Move with a three-man chrono. He might look at damage to CC actually on the very end of this. They take up a load through it. A big kill there for Digital Chaos. I don't know if they can push any further forward, but Jason just raised TP's back to safety, and Shazam will cut their losses.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
So, Shazam probably okay with that because they still get a side of Rax. Same time, really nice chrono from Move, and Shazam won't be okay with that. Like, they don't feel like it was unnecessary to get caught in a 3-hero chrono. Well, Emesis is looking for revenge.
Weeha. Open wounds onto Brax and kills off the four. Brax is focusing the Doom over onto MSS. They could look to chase this one out as well, but Grimcore is down for 30 seconds, blinking four. In SVG, the Enchantress has already sprinted down towards this area. The Hex, how fast can MSS come out of this Doom? It's a little bit slow when he lasts himself. He's got the Hex available. Maybe even blinking away from this as well. He's going to get himself a little bit further away, and there's no chase on. He's out. Attacks Resolution, and we are. They want to jump in again. Resolution with the old four. They're so aggressively positioned that he cannot get himself into this fight anymore. And the Hex turnaround, we are trapped up. MSS still trying to save himself in this battle, but SVG has the damage output to kill off Saxa, and we are hot retreat, hot pursuit, whatever they call it. Shazam, they want to kill more off. Misery Witch Doctor, I think you're dead. Just give yourself up here. The castle will not bounce. And surely, even with that Dream Coil well placed onto a bunch of them, Misery Witch Doctor will lose his life.
Time the Siege Creep does. But so I think for DC, so that's something. But you can kind of see what they're thinking there. They finally got the Doom and OD who didn't have an agent. And I think they feel entitled to make that kill. And I actually really thought they would. Lifestealer jumps and Tuck catches up, Lifestealer can do the damage output. But just as the Lifestealer gets on the OD, the Doom runs out and there's a self Astral and Kawaii.
And then so, a force down.
Yeah, I mean, if the timing was ever so slightly better, the Lifestealer would have killed the OD in basically half a second, 1 second maybe even. But the Doom just runs out exactly then. Look, it was the beginnings of something promising for DC, and they felt they needed to get more, they didn't get more, and as a result, they're
Radiant's
probably going to be punished here.
Under attack.
SVG is pretty far away from this. The Shazam only have the four of them, but they'll jump in and wow, move! Jeez! Absolutely annihilating for the roar down to Misery. Looking for the kill of MSS, but it's still a great from Jason as well. The full staff misses on the front line. Cast death was good with the Maledict. The bounces are brilliant! MSS having roared to try and push them back a little bit. Brax still dropping low. The Resolution phase is out of this reality. Rack dropping very quickly though, and SVG, the Enchantress, who made the long run over from the Dire Ancients, is still going to get caught in the Dream Call from Resolution up on the front line to attack this one out. But MSS damage up from Delphine Orb, but still holding up the center clips. Oh, we are. Ah, there we go. GG is called. Mitra just taps out until Shazam, you take it. Game number one goes the way of Shazam, and this for Chaos. My draft looks okay, but they've got a lot of work to do.
I mean, I really think that's very good. As Shazam hit their main timing, you see have that jump in the lane where they try and force things without any vision at all, and they lose, what was it, 3 or 4 heroes at exactly the worst time in the game, right when they were most vulnerable to Shazam, and that was before the first and the second rush, I think, and I don't know, to me it just highlights the importance of recognizing the timing windows of enemy teams and having the appropriate